If you're like me and travel a lot, then you probably use a lot of other computers apart from your own. Then this video is for you. First of all, if you're using the same password for different accounts, you gotta change that. But that's not what we are talking about today. Today we're talking about how do you access passwords from one place. There are different apps that used to do this, but now Google Chrome is a powerful tool that can help you keep your passwords in one place. You can use it like a flash drive, if you will. Let me explain. It's almost freezing outside. Let me just take you to my computer and I'll show you what I mean. First of all, in your home computer or your personal laptop, open Google Chrome. If you are opening this for the first time or you haven't already done this, then you gotta add a user. Just click on this avatar icon over here. So you need to turn on sync in order to add a user. So just go ahead and turn on sync. Sorry, that's in French. That's my Gmail account. Notice I didn't have to type at gmail.com because this is obviously a Google account, so you don't need to do that. That's another tip. I'm gonna type in my password and I'm in. So it's gonna ask you, do you wanna turn on Chrome Sync? This is what we're talking about actually. This is how you save your passwords. That's the most important part, and that's what we're talking about today. Chrome Sync. Let's turn that on. You'll see that now in the place of my avatar, you have my logo here and there's another logo here. That's confusing. That's poor design. Let's give it a second there. My bookmarks just kicked in and in like a minute or two, sometimes 3 minutes, I've noticed that my theme will kick in. In the last video, I spoke about a black theme where everything is black and it looks awesome. It doesn't hit your eye. I chose a nice black theme for Chrome. Check out my previous video if you want to know how to turn that on in your computer. And notice this settings logo is now an exclamation point. That's because since you just signed in, it's gonna ask you for permissions for the extension. So there's a search extension for my Mac. I'm gonna hit enable. Then there's another extension. I'm gonna hit enable. So now all the extensions are there. It just kicked in. And now you have all your stuff here. That's all that it takes. So on your home computer, once you have added a person, now go ahead and do all of your browsing. What I mean is, if you open a new account in a new website, I use this website called Interpals for learning French. I used to use this to find pen pals, people that I can email now and then. So notice that my email address and my password is already saved. It's saved on my Google Chrome. And it was not this computer. It was a computer from, I don't know, 5 or 6 years ago. It was not this computer. But when I log into my Google Chrome on this computer, it knows my password. So that's what we are talking about. And now it works, you know. If I open Facebook, obviously I'm logged out, but then it remembers my password, you know. So that's a litmus test to show you that these passwords really work. If I go to my email, this is my Gmail email. And since I just signed into my Google account, my Gmail is directly going to open it. Now, the most important part is to log out. Now, when you say log out, you can go to your Google account and log out, but that's not what I'm talking about. Remember, we added a user. You got to sign out of that. So if you hit your avatar over here, you see manage people. And under manage people, make sure that you remove this person if it's not your personal computer, if you're using a friend's computer. If you don't do this, then what's gonna happen is it's gonna have all the passwords saved, all your history, your bookmarks saved. Now, if there are two people using the same computer, then what you can do is add a person. You can choose an image. For now, I'll just choose an alien's face and I'll call this alien. And if I hit add, notice that it's not the same theme as before. Also, that's my avatar over here. And this is the new alien avatar. And of course, it's gonna ask you for permissions again. This is a new alien avatar. And then you turn on sync and sign into your email account. And now you notice that there are two different, not tabs, not windows, there are two different users. And this is key if there are several people using a computer. If you trust the other guy, then don't log out. But if you don't trust the other guy and it's not a computer, then just hit manage people and remove this person. This is important. If you don't do this, guys, again, using this tip is awesome. But if you don't do this, then you're gonna lose your data. Someone else is gonna use your email and whatnot and change your password, and something terrible might happen. Now you can log in to any user account, any password from any computer, only if you enter your Gmail account password. That's the power of this users on Google Chrome.
One ring to rule them all.
Before you guys leave, can you think about one person who struggles with passwords all the time? Maybe your dad, your mom, maybe it's a brother or a cousin. Send them this video so that they don't struggle with memorizing passwords or writing them down somewhere which can get dangerous, and they can just sign in this way. Of course, this does not work for phones, you know, because it does not add in the passwords on your apps. Maybe Google will do that soon, but for now, it's only on Google Chrome, and it's only for the tabs on Google Chrome. So yeah, that one person you thought about, send him this video. Don't keep the good stuff for yourself. Help a homie. If this video helped you, hit the like button. If you haven't already, then subscribe to my channel. And while you're at it, hit the bell. That way, every time I put up a video, you'll know that I've put up a video. Take care of yourself. Be warm this winter. Hang on, why winter? I'll be back next week. Then there's a lot of winter. Take care of yourself and keep learning.